When we got in to my father, he said, "Well, Lily," he said, "I suppose you know what this means." I said, "Oh, no. Oh, no, not that." He said, "Yes, Lily." She broke down then and she said, "But your beautiful life, James." She says, "Your beautiful life." And he said, "Wasn't it full life, Lillian? Isn't this a good end?"
Easter morn to a city far away. There are mid lines of marching men and squadrons passed me by. No pipe dead hum nor battle drum did sound that thread that day. But the angelus bear the nephews were rang out and the foggy dew. Right proudly high over Dublin town they hung it the flag of war. For it was better to die beneath an Irish sky than at Sula or Siddlebar. And from the plains of Royal Meath, strong men came hurrying through, while Britannia's sons with their long-range guns sailed in by the foggy
black, and the sound of each and every rifle's crack made perfidious Albion reel. Mid the leaded rail, seven tongues of flame did shine with the lines of steel. By each shining blade, a prayer was said to Ireland, her sons and daughters be true. And when the morning broke, still the war flag shook at its fold on the foggy dew.
But the bravest fell on the sullen bell, rang mournfully. Died on that Easter tide in the springtime of the year, and the world did gaze in deep amaze at those stout-hearted men and women too, who bore the fight so that freedom shine and the foggy dew.
possessing the land, but our wild geese go, that small nations shall be free. But their lonely graves are by Suvla's waves on the fringe of the great North Sea. Oh, had they died by Pierce's side, or fought with Cabra, their names we would keep where Rufina sleep beneath the shroud of the foggy dew. So back to the glen I rode again, my heart with grief, 'twas sore. For I parted with those gallant men I never would see no more. And to and fro in my dreams I will go, and I kneel and pray for you. For slavery fled, a rebel dead, when you fell and the foe